As we approach the end of our series on the 1980 election that plunged the country into war, with a look at the key personalities that participated, we now come to candidate Yoweri Museveni, the man who led Uganda patriotic movement. What did he do after the December 10th election? New Vision TV summarizes Museveni's post-election struggle. The UPM leader, who was also the vice chairman of the military commission that organized the 1980 election, had been warning that should it be rigged, he would go to the bush and wage war against the fraudulent government that would be installed. And since the ground was blatant and even in favor of the UPC, it was just a matter of waiting for December for the war to start. By the end of January 1981, preparations for war were almost ready, and the final meeting to plan the attack was held in the Makindye residence of Matthew Rukikayure on February 3rd. The model Museveni chose was of a homegrown people's protracted war rather than one supported from outside. On February 6th, he led 40 men, who included intelligence officer Paul Kagame, former art teacher Eli Tumwine, a young experienced fighter Fred Rijema, and they had only 27 guns. They attacked Kabamba Military Training School, hoping to collect more guns. The truck they used was driven by Andrew Lutaya. During the war that lasted 5 years, Museveni's guerrillas boasted of using the very government they were fighting as the main supplier of weapons. The war progressed with attacks on security installations to collect guns. Later in the year, meetings were held between Yoweri Museveni and finally, his Popular Resistance Army marched with Yusuf Lule's Uganda Freedom Fighters to form the National Resistance Army, or Movement NRA. The chairman was Lule, and Museveni was the overall military commander. The first army commander of the NRA was Ahmed Seguia, who did not live to the end of the war. Key NRA players on the external wing included lawyer Amama Mbabazi, Samu Njuba, Eria Kategaya, and Dr. Samson Chiseka, who ran a large medical practice in Nairobi. Museveni's army grew as more young men, including highly educated ones, joined him. From Makerere University came people like Mujisha Mutu, Aronda Nyakairima, and Siranga Ranga. From outside came others like Dr. Chiza Besije, who was working in a Nairobi hospital, and lawyer Kale Kaihura, who had just completed his master's in law at London School of Economics. But the NRA did not hold territory at first, and it was highly mobile. In December 1983, the government chief of staff, Major General Oita Ojok, died in a helicopter crash as he supervised operations against Museveni's forces in Luwero. This helped reduce the morale of the government army and boosting that of the rebels. In January 1985, exactly 1 year before the NRA captured power, its chairman, Yusuf Lule, died of kidney failure in England. Museveni assumed both the political leadership and the military command of NRM/NRA. On July 27, 1985, the army overthrew Milton Obote. The junta, led by General Tito Okello, sued for peace, and talks started in Nairobi between them and the NRA under the chairmanship of President Daniel Arap Moi. The talks lasted until December 17, 1985, when the Nairobi Peace Agreement was signed by Yoweri Museveni and Tito Okello. However, its implementation required that atrocities by the Uganda army against the people stop. The Okello lacked control over the unruly soldiers. The NRA moved and made a final assault of Kampala, declaring itself the new government on January 26, 1986, with Yoweri Museveni as president. He had taken exactly the same period that Semogele agreed to spend in opposition, 5 years. Museveni started putting together a broad-based government, which pledged to rule for 4 years and organize general elections. Museveni's ascendance to power brought a lot of relief and jubilation in Kampala as Uganda prepared to start a new journey to peace and prosperity. How far have these been achieved?